In addition to the biological treatment, physical and chemical treatment is really important, especially when we're trying to remove those compounds that we can't remove biologically. So that COD portion that is not biologically degradable, things like chlorides, metals, all those can only be removed through physical and chemical. We can't do it with biological. So we've got things like air stripping to take out volatile things like ammonia and some of those dissolved gases, methane. Dissolved air flotation can help remove some grease and solids. Gravity settling, just like our first step primary clarifier and normal wastewater treatment process, we can get some of that high solids load out. Coagulation, flocculation can encourage some of those suspended solids to come out. Membrane filtration and reverse osmosis is going to, you know, go from small solids all the way down to the molecular level, and reverse osmosis will get us very high effluent quality. It'll remove those chlorides. It just takes a lot of energy to do it. So you might do some other solids removal steps before you get there. And then you can do activated carbon filtration, which will have that adsorbent effect for maybe some of those toxic organics that you don't want getting out. And then sand filtration, which has that physical filtration effect at a lower cost and energy requirement than some of those membrane filtration options. Those all work. Those are all things you also see in industrial wastewater treatment and domestic wastewater treatment. We've also got chemical treatment. So we can do chemical oxidation, for example, with hypochlorite, just like we do for our disinfection step for our domestic wastewater treatment, as well as advanced oxidation processes. So using combinations of ozone, UV, hydrogen peroxide, there's an iron-mediated reaction called a Fenton process. All these generate hydroxyl radicals, which have an even higher oxidation potential than just simple chemical oxidants. And these have been applied successfully for leachate for degrading those organics that are really hard to address in other ways, and especially with decoloring it, because that's a key thing that we don't like to see in the environment, is that black leachate being discharged. So advanced oxidation processes are a successful way of addressing some of those organics that you can't address with our biological processes if they're not degradable enough. So all this, I know there's a lot of things on this list. Hopefully it's things you've seen before in other courses. So at the end of the day, just know that all the conventional technologies in the toolbox might be applied to leachate treatment in four specific situations based on that leachate quality and the effluent requirements for that specific location they're discharging from. I'll give you an example of one plant. This plant happens to look very, very much like a domestic wastewater treatment system. This is the leachate treatment system used at Green Lane Landfill, owned by the City of Toronto. So you can look at the process train here, and it looks very similar to domestic wastewater treatment. A couple little differences. So coming in, we've got a pre-aeration because our liquid's probably going to be anaerobic coming in from the bottom of the landfill. So we want to make sure that while it's sitting in our leachate treatment facility, it's not continuing to produce methane and things like that. So there's a pre-aeration to start aerating it. You can see they're dosing phosphoric acid, and that's to adjust that nitrogen to phosphorus ratio to make sure our microbes are going to be happy later on. Then we've got a coagulation flocculation process. So in a lot of domestic wastewater treatment plant, we go directly into the primary clarifier because we've got a lot of solids in here. Here we've got some more suspended solids that we want to address right off the bat. So we've got some coagulation flocculation to enhance that. Next, we're going into an activated sludge process. It's split up with an anoxic and aerated zone to get some denitrification going on, and also to enhance that denitrification, we're adding methanol into the system. So that's an additional carbon source to help with the denitrification process. And you also see that with domestic wastewater treatment. That's sometimes you need sometimes something that you need to add. Coming out of that activated sludge process, we're doing another coagulation, adding some more alum and another secondary clarifier. Sludge is coming down out of the clarifier, and that's going to be aerobically digested, dewatered, and put back in the landfill. And then our secondary effluent is going to be ozonated for a disinfection step, filtered, and then discharged to a treatment wetland, which acts as a polishing step to treat any additional contaminants before it goes into the final receiving environment. So a lot of things look similar to a traditional domestic wastewater treatment plant. We've just got some little tweaks, the phosphoric acid, coagulation, flocculation. And just to, you can't see it in this figure, but just to emphasize how the scale differs between leachate treatment and domestic wastewater treatment. So Green Lane Landfill, one of the biggest landfills in Ontario. But if you look at the leachate treatment plant, here's the building. So if you've ever been to a wastewater treatment plant, you know, it's like a huge campus and there's all these big outdoor tanks. So the whole thing fits in this little building. Here are some of their tanks. So flocculation, coagulation tank. These, if you can kind of get a sense for the scale, are, you know, no higher, no taller than a person. So just like a few cubic meters in volume or less. So way smaller than you'd see at a wastewater treatment plant. And then here's the aeration, or the activated sludge tank. And you can see the aerated zone in the front with all the bubbles coming up, and then the anoxic zone just behind where we'd be getting that denitrification going on. And then recycle between them, just like you'd see in a domestic wastewater treatment plant. So that's what the plant looks like. Just kind of like a mini wastewater treatment plant, and then some little differences. But we've got a whole lot of options in our menu, and these could all be successfully employed to treat leachate to the standard that's required in whatever jurisdiction you're operating in.